Hello, welcome. In this series, we're continuing to build energy in our bodies through strength and flexibility and movement and awareness in our breath. So please make your space the most comfortable space for you, whether that means sitting on cushions or books or pillows or blocks if you have them. We can use the blocks and pillows today towards the end of our practice. So we'll meet on our mats, seated. Coming to any comfortable seats. What do you need here? What do you need for your physical body to feel more at ease in this posture? What else do you need? Do you need a sigh? You need to shake your head. Arrive how you need. Invite your eyes closed. Bring your internal awareness to your breath. Observing the whole cycle of your breath, starting at the tips of your nose, going up through the nostrils, towards the back of the throat, and down into the deepest part of your lungs, filling up. And as you exhale, feel the breath move in reverse, emptying the lungs out. Feeling the breath move through the back of the throat and out the nostrils. And it doesn't have to take you that long, but observe your breath as it flows in and up and flows out. Take your time, be patient. Form a connection to your breath. One of the easiest ways or most direct ways that we can get in touch with our energy and change our energy is through our breath. So take a few breaths here on your own. Breathing exercise together today to increase energy, to increase prana, to increase the flow of energy in our bodies. We'll use the right hand. Take your right peace fingers to the forehead. Close the left nostril with your right ring finger and breathe in through the right. Open the left. Close the right nostril with your thumb. Exhale on the left. Open the right, close the left nostril, breathe in through the right. Open the left, close the right nostril, breathe out the left. Open the right, close the left, breathe in through the right nostril. Open the left, close the right, breathe out the left. Continue this cycle, breathing in right, breathing out left, breathing in right, breathing out left. Continue several more rounds. Feel the breath like a circle, breathing in through the right side and out through the left. And the breath is flowing from one side to the other. Take three more rounds. Last round. energy. Feel the breath moving in both sides, filling you up, emptying you out. Next breath in, reach your arms up. Exhale, bring your hands to your heart. Breathe in and lift your arms. Lift your chin. Exhale, hands to your heart. Breathe in, lift your arms up. Exhale, bring your right hand down and lean over to the right. And breathe in, lift your arms up, extend through the spine. Exhale, over to the left. Inhale, reach your arms up, and exhale, twist to the right. Inhale, reach your arms up. Exhale, twist over to the left. Inhale, reach your arms up. Exhale, release your hands, interlace them behind the back and open your chest. You can do anything with your head. You can look over your shoulders. You can look down or up. Bring your head to neutral before releasing your hands. And we'll come onto our hands and knees. Take a few rounds of cat and cow. Arching and grounding your back together with your breath. From the center, tuck your toes under. If they aren't already, sit back onto your heels, interlace your fingers, open your chest. You can stay upright, you can come into rabbit pose. If your hair is like mine, you might have a little trouble. You can bring your forehead down, or you can bring the top of your head down, lifting your knuckles up. Slowly release, coming back upright. Bring your hands down, come into downward facing dog. Step your right foot forward and bring your left knee down. And float yourself up, breathe in. Exhale, bring your hands down and lift your back knee. And do the same thing, floating up as you breathe in and bringing your hands down as you exhale. Step to downward facing dog and switch your sides. Bring the left foot forward and the right knee down and lift your arms up. Bring your hands down as you exhale. Bring your right knee off the floor and come to a high lunge. And exhale, bring your hands down and step your right foot forward and extend through your spine. Make your torso, your spine, parallel to the floor. Just as much as you're pushing into your legs, push your legs into your hands. We're working the stamina and the energy in our legs today. Breathe in. Exhale, fold. Inhale, come all the way up. Open your throat, lift your chest. Exhale, hands to your heart. Half sun salutation. Inhale, lift your arms. And exhale, fold forward. Inhale, flatten your back. Exhale, fold towards your legs. Inhale, come all the way up. Exhale, bring your hands to your heart. Step your left foot back and take warrior legs, warrior two. Right knee over the ankle, but look at your foot. Check out your big toe. We want the right leg to be active, but lengthening through the groin. So the right knee moves to the right very slightly. So look at your back leg. Build the posture slowly, steadily, arms out to the sides. And as you breathe in, straighten your front leg and lift up. And as you exhale, bend the front leg, warrior two. Inhale, arms straight, spine straight, legs straight. Exhale, bend your front knee. One more, inhale, and exhale. Bring your hands down. Step your back foot forward, flatten your back. Hands and shins together. Exhale, fold towards your legs. Inhale, come all the way up. And exhale, bring your hands to your heart. Step your right foot back. Find your legs. No rushing to add the arms. Find your legs first. Feel the whole right foot on the mat. See your left big toe. And then float your arms up. Keep your legs strong and your torso nice and soft and fluid. And breathe in and straighten your legs and your arms. And exhale, bend your knees. Breathe in, straighten. Breathe out, warrior two. Breathe in, straighten. And breathe out, warrior two. Bring your hands down and step two, downward facing dog for a moment. Then shift into plank pose and lower to your belly. As you breathe in, come into cobra pose. Open the front side. Exhale, lift your hips up and back. Take an extra pause, an extra breath. Step your right foot forward. Bring your back foot down, but come up with straight legs this time. Send your arms up to the side. Send your hips back as you lean forward and come into triangle pose. You don't have to have that right hand on the floor. You can have it on your shin or on a block. Squeeze your legs up and into the sockets, opening your chest. Come upright and lean back for a reverse triangle, left hand on the leg. Do that one more time, arms up. Send your hips back, bring your right hand to the ground or to your shin or to your block, triangle pose. And then come upright and lean back. And come upright, bring your hands down, step to downward facing dog, and then shift plank, and then exhale, lower, and then breathe in, cobra, open chest, stretching your belly, exhale, downward facing dog, left foot steps forward, right foot on the ground, and come up with nice long legs, extend your arms out, start to lean forward. You want to reach something forward, and then bring your left hand to your leg, and open your chest to the right. Like you're trying to fit your whole body in between two panes of glass. We're opening our hips to the right, we're opening our chest to the right. And then push into your feet and slowly rotate yourself up, and slowly rotate yourself back. Right hand on the leg, push away from your leg, and then come upright, and then lean back into triangle pose. Imagine pushing through the right foot as you extend long through the spine, extending your spine forward, and come upright, and lean back. And then come upright, bring your hands to the floor. Beautiful. Step your right foot forward, flatten your back. Inhale. Exhale, fold towards your legs. And then inhale, come all the way up to standing. And exhale, bring your hands to your heart. Pause for a breath. Step your left foot back. Bend the right knee. Warrior two. Extend your arms up to the sides. Lean back, come into reverse warrior two. Straighten your front leg, reverse triangle. Bend your front knee. Imagine it's tracking right over the ankle. And then breathe in and come upright. And come into extended side angle. Bring your right forearm to your leg. See if you can push down even more. As you push your elbow into your thigh, pull your ribs and extend long through the left side of your body. Use your right elbow to help open your right hip even a tiny bit more. Take a breath in and exhale. Bring your hands down. Step your back foot forward. Flatten your back. Inhale. Exhale. Pull towards your legs. Inhale. Come all the way up. And exhale. Hands to your heart. Step your right foot back. Find warrior legs, warrior two. Left toes facing forward, left knee facing forward. Right foot parallel to the back of your mat. Bring your right hand up to your leg and lean back. Stretch the left side of your body. Start to straighten your left leg with control. Feel like you're pushing down into the floor and extending up through the left fingertips. Knowing that your ankle is there, bend your left knee. Come back into reverse warrior. And then come upright. And bring your left forearm onto your leg. And reach your right arm over your head. Push down into your left elbow. Push your left elbow into your left leg, rolling it open just a little bit. Inhale. And exhale. Bring your hands down. Step your back foot forward. Flatten your back. Inhale. Exhale. Bring your hands behind the legs. Forward fold. Inhale. Come all the way up. And exhale. Bring your hands to your heart. Pause here for a moment. What do you need? What does your body need? Do you need to bend your knees? Do you need a sigh? Take it. We'll come into tree pose. Having all the weight in your left foot, take your right foot to your left leg, the calf, or holding the ankle, you can bring it up into the groin. Feel connection here, your legs pressing together. Bring your hands to your heart. Take three breaths. Feel the sturdiness, steadiness in your legs. Slowly release your foot down. Step into the right foot. Bring your left foot to your right leg. Maybe the calf, the toes are facing down. Or you can hold your ankle and bring your foot into your inner thigh. Feel yourself tall and steady, grounded. Feel the strength and the energy of your legs, everything that your legs provide for you. Take one more breath. Go ahead and release your foot. Step to the long side of your mat if you aren't already, and separate your legs. Separate your leg nice and wide. Have your legs straight, your toes facing out, and then slowly bend your knees over your ankles. Bring your hands to your heart. Try to tuck your tailbone a little bit and open the knees a little more, and lift the right heel, and lower the right heel, and lift the left heel. Lower your left heel and lift the right heel. Lower your right heel and lift the left heel. And lower the left heel and then lift them both. Steady, legs strong. And then press your heels down. Straighten your legs. Turn your toes forward and we'll fold forward. Hands to the ground. You can bend your knees in order for you to get there a little easier. Shake your head. Lift your chest and walk your heels in and your toes in and your heels in and come into a squat. Hands to your heart. And we're going to come to seated, so if you'd like to, you can use your hands behind you to come down, or you can reach forward and drop your hips. Bring your feet together. Butterfly. Sitting up tall, holding your feet or your ankles. You're welcome here to stay upright. Lifting up out of the pelvis. For those of you who enjoy folding forward, you can fold forward. Holding your chest towards your feet. Come upright. Cross your legs. we did in the beginning of our practice, lift your arms and exhale, bring your right hand down and lean over to the right. Notice any difference in your body now. And inhale, come upright, lift your chest, and exhale, lean over to the left. Inhale, come up. Exhale, twist your spine to the right. Inhale from the center. Exhale, twist yourself to the left. Inhale, center, lift your arms. Exhale, release your hands. Interlace your fingers behind the back and open your chest. Anything you want with your neck, notice what has shifted, what has loosened. Release your hands. Take a breath. And today our yin posture, our relaxing posture, is going to use the wall. If you don't have an accessible wall to you, that's also fine. You can use your mat or the floor. And simply lift your legs into the air. Notice that my legs aren't straight. My heels are over my hips. And that might mean the legs are straight, but we don't want to use muscular action. We've used our legs a lot in our practice today. So if at all possible, bend your knees and let your legs dangle in the air. But if you have a wall nearby, you can take this posture at the wall. So you can scoot yourself. I'm quite close, so it takes not a lot of finesse to get there. Hips towards the wall and legs up the wall. Reminding yourself that this isn't an active posture. You don't need to straighten your legs and press your legs into the wall. If they bend, if the heels slide down, if your legs are more open, that's also fine. What we're working here is to drain the blood out of the legs, to restore the energy in the leg, to bring fresh circulation into the legs when we come out. So take your time getting into the posture. I recommend allowing the knees to be soft in whatever variation you're in. Tuck your chin slightly so the forehead is higher than the chin. And then breathe. Hips and your spine and your arms and your head heavy against the floor. Your legs light. right here for 5 more breaths. 5 more breaths is the minimum. If you'd like to stay here 5 more minutes, pause the video. This is an unbelievable posture for restoration. All your systems. Let your knees slowly bend, bringing your knees into your chest, arms out to the sides. Let your legs fall over to the right, twist your spine. Center and over to the left, twist your spine. Lay into the fetal position on your left. And then slowly come upright. Come up to seated. Find a comfortable seat. Gratitude for your legs, for their stamina, for their power. Gratitude for your heart and your breath, for your life. Thank you for sharing your practice with me. Namaste.